why come and get a bachelor's in electrical engineering or a bachelor's in computer engineering? Because when you have that degree, and when you have that degree with the Purdue stamp of approval, the world is your oyster.
I don't think there's a better place than Purdue.
We tackle just about every problem there is in electrical and computer engineering and beyond. We think about the energy transition. We think about artificial intelligence. We think about autonomy. We think about space. We think about semiconductors and the semiconductor supply chain. And we've got faculty that do each and every one of those things here in the department. And so if you're a student who shows up interested in one of those topics, you'll find a home here. Purdue ECE offers two separate degrees. We offer a bachelor's degree in electrical engineering and a bachelor's degree in computer engineering. There's a lot of overlap between the degrees. The biggest difference is that computer engineering, you spend a little bit more time thinking about programming. You spend a little bit more time working with computer hardware. Whereas electrical engineering brings in electromagnetics. You think about devices and how transistors actually work. We pride ourselves in actually having very flexible degrees that let students really pursue their passions. It is the largest ECE department in the country. We have 120 faculty, 2,300 undergraduate students, 1,700 graduate students. That scale brings these incredible benefits in terms of your ability to find a home and find ideas that excite you and people that inspire you and projects that spark your passion. A group of four undergraduate students in ECE built a robot that can solve a Rubik's Cube faster than anybody has ever done before. They beat the world record that was set by a multinational team of engineers at Mitsubishi. These are the kinds of things that you get the facilities and the resources and the people and the ideas to accomplish.
There is opportunity everywhere you look. If you are a motivated student and you want to achieve your goals of going into industry or research.
If you have a degree in electrical engineering, or a degree in computer engineering, you can go work at just about any company out there, and our students do. You can find yourself at Meta and Apple and Google and OpenAI. Any kind of company that has any kind of technical needs, they need ECE students. What makes Purdue ECE so special is the people. It's 120 incredible faculty who do an amazing job of teaching. They're phenomenal researchers. They work really closely with lots of students, including lots of undergraduate students, on cutting-edge research problems.
I was given the opportunity to do paid research related to semiconductors and designing cells for semiconductor devices.
There are all of these research opportunities that you have as an undergraduate student, and that means that our students go on to graduate school around the country and around the world. We've completely revamped our undergraduate labs that give students training on state-of-the-art, industry-grade machinery. We have student groups that build battle bots. We have student groups that do electric racing. We have student groups that help with the space program.
Purdue Solar Racing was a really great opportunity to get hands-on and develop some really cool components for the Purdue Solar Racing car.
We launched programs in Indianapolis. This is the Elmore Family School of Electrical and Computer Engineering offering programs, courses, research in Indianapolis. It's the same courses, it's the same faculty, it's the same rigor, it's the same curriculum.
Purdue ECE has been a really transformative experience for me.
The foundation that you get here in ECE really sets the stage for you to go just about anywhere. You can go work in space, you can go work in cutting edge semiconductor companies, you can go work at cutting edge artificial intelligence companies. If you want to get involved in cutting edge research and you want to define what the next generation of self-driving cars might look like, what the next generation of data centers will be, if you want to define how generative AI is going to work for the next 50 years, you can do that with an electrical and computer engineering degree. You can do just about anything that you can imagine